Now, my friend, now, as I said in part one, Jesus prayed for that to the Father that we would stay in that name. There's not another name under heaven whereby man can be saved. So oftentimes we proclaim him, we call on him, we'll pray to God and put him at the tail end of a prayer or something. I'm telling you, this Jesus is the first and he's the last. He's the mighty God and the mighty Savior. You run to your Father and you run to the only name given under heaven whereby man can be saved, and that's the name of Jesus. Now Jesus also, just like Peter, told us how to be saved. And it's one and the same way, for there's one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. Now, how did Jesus himself say it?
Okay, everybody knows Matthew 28:19, but I'm going to go up to verse 18. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. All power in heaven and earth is given unto Jesus. He said, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world.
Oh, glory to God. Anybody love the name of the Father? Anybody love the name of the Son? Anybody love the name of the Holy Ghost? Well, Jesus plainly stated, go into all the world and baptize in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Who is your Father? Who is your Son? Who is your Holy Ghost? There's only one name under heaven whereby man can be saved. Jesus said, go and baptize in the name. Peter knew what he was talking about when he said, you must repent, every one of you, and be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. They understood. People out there beyond Jesus could not understand the name. They couldn't understand that he's the Father. They had to be baptized in his name. Many asked them, what shall we do to receive the Holy Ghost? They didn't know even if there was such a thing as the Holy Ghost. Until you know Jesus, you will never know the Holy Ghost, because the Holy Ghost is the Spirit of God, Jesus Christ, walking among us. Jesus said, Father, keep them in the name that you've given them. How do you stay in the name? Jesus came in his Father's name. Jesus, the Son, is named Jesus. The Holy Ghost, he said, and the Father will send in my name. Who is the name of the Holy Ghost? The Spirit of truth that came in the name of Jesus. Who is the Father? Jesus came in the name of the Father. Obey what Jesus said. Run and be dunked and be washed from your feet to your head in the one name that he given us up in heaven and up on earth. There's not another name. Do you love your Father? Be baptized in the name of your Father. Do you love your Son? Be baptized in the name of your Son. Do you love the Spirit of God? Be baptized in the name of the Spirit of God. What name did he pray? Father, keep them in the name. Not a bunch of names. There's only one name. That name is Jesus. Don't take him out of your heart. Don't take him out of your church. Without Jesus Christ, you can say God all you want to. There is no power there. You've got to have and proclaim the name of God, the name of his Son, the name of him that walked among us in the flesh. God Almighty is a good God. He became man like we was, known as the Son. They asked Jesus, are you the Son of God? He said, you say that I am. But when he got down to nitty gritty and told them, I'm much more than a son, they gasped for air. They said, you being a man, maketh yourself God. Anybody making him God? We don't make him God. He made him own self for God. Jesus, God, came down in the flesh of Jesus. I've heard one person say, God can be anything you want him to be. They tried that in the Bible. They made a golden calf. They wanted to see God, so they made a golden calf. It didn't work. God got angry. He took away all their gold and stuff. Did you make idols? There's no idol. You can make no thing, nobody, a God. Only God makes him himself who he wants to be. And my Bible tells me he was Jesus. Jesus, God came down in the flesh. He says he is the very express image of God. The very express image of God. No golden calf will work. Nothing you put in an idol will not work. If you want God, you run to Jesus. If you want to talk to God, you run to Jesus. Jesus' words, he said, my words are not mine, but him that sent me. So do you want to hear God? Do you want to talk to God? Run to Jesus. Because when Jesus speaks, it's God Almighty. Do you want God Almighty? Jesus. You call Jesus. You scream out Jesus. He is the way maker. He's the one that died for you. If there's no Jesus, there's no heaven. I don't know any other God that said he was going to make a place for me. Oh, Lord God, he laid down his life. God himself come down in the person of Jesus Christ. You cannot kill God. God is a spirit, but he became a man, and that man was crucified and died, but he rose again. Do you want to rise again? You better be in Jesus. If you're not in Jesus, you won't get out of that grave, because he's the resurrector. Jesus is true. He's life. He's your vine. He's everything that you need. You need a God, you run to the Son of God. God himself that was in the beginning. The Word was with God. The Word was God. He wasn't just with him. He was him. God Almighty is Jesus. You stay in that name. You do all things in that name. You baptize in that name. It's not another name under heaven whereby man can be saved. Oh, glory to God. Holy Ghost, keep us in the name. Holy Ghost, open our eyes up. Holy Ghost, come upon us. Show us plenty of the Father. Jesus, Jesus, one name. I'm speaking to you, God. In one name I call upon my heavenly Father. Oh, glory. Jesus Christ can save you. He's not just a savior. He's a healer. That's why you got to pray in the name. You got to do all things in that name. Prayer won't go nowhere unless it's done in the name.